Hey all, so today is another interesting tutorial for you all. This is for this month's challenge. This month's challenge is all about masculine products or masculine projects. So I'm going to be using this Glory Days vintage paper from Craft Angles. This is a beautiful paper. So it absolutely depicts the love for sports. It has nice newsprint background, a very distressed background with pictures of rugby, golf and such. It's a beautiful paper. You can do lots of great things with this paper. And you know, the best part about Craft Angles decoupage paper is that the price is absolutely economical and wonderful, and you get four A4 sheets in a pack and with beautiful prints. So please do check out their collection, their vintage collection, their decoupage papers. It's just lovely. Yeah, so coming back to our monthly challenge, I'm going to be using this MDF. I am not going to reveal what I am going to be doing with this, but you will see it as we go along. So let's first prep this MDF base. Though these decoupage sheets are thick, they are around 70 GSM paper. They're not like decoupage napkins, but they are quite thick. You can straight away paste them on your MDF or any base, but I would highly recommend that you always prime your MDF surfaces with a primer, either gesso or white acrylic or any primer. The reason being, MDF is a porous material. When I say porous material, these have, the way they are structured, are, they have a lot of pores in them. So when you put on any glue or paint or anything on it straight away, it's going to seep inside. The board will kind of suck the product and you will not get a good finish. So it's really, really, really highly advisable that you prime the surface first. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do now. I will use a roller, it's easier for larger surfaces. So I'm going to take some primer. I'm using gesso here, white gesso. I find roller brushes easier for larger surfaces, so that's what I'm doing. And this also gives a very good coverage, gets done faster. So I will just go ahead and prime the entire MDF product that I have here. So our base is ready. I have primed it. I just gave one coat, like a whitewash kind of a coat. Because we are not using a tissue, but we are using a decoupage paper which is much thicker. So just a whitewashed one coat is fine. So now what I am going to do is, I am going to pick up this beautiful paper here. And I will be using some elements of this paper. And say for example, stick this here. Yeah, but before that, I'm only going to use some elements, but before that I will be teaching you another beautiful and very easy but amazing result technique. This is also a distressed technique, but it adds to the old world charm and it gives that grunge kind of look. So I will be teaching you that, how to do it. You can use that in various projects. It's an awesome technique. I just love doing it. It really gives adds to the vintagey, antique, distressed look of your whole project. So I will be showing you how to do that. Before that, let's just see where I want to place what picture. So yeah, I'm just trying to place it and see what I want, where I want. I'm just going to mark so I can just cut it off. So I have cut these elements that we need to stick on. Now I will be teaching you the other technique that I told about. Now Craft Angles has really done a great job coming up with this vintage paper, newsprint paper. But if you can't get hold of it, there is a technique that you can use to kind of bring the same effect on your paper. What you need to do is take a newspaper and take your coffee or tea decoction and just brush the newspaper with that and stain them with coffee or tea concentrate. And once it dries, you will kind of get this effect with a tinge of the vintage brown. And if you want more depth to your vintage look, you can do the same process on the newspaper again and again to give it more depth and more color, more brown tinge. And that is an easy DIY that you can use to get this vintage newsprint effect. Beyond that, the other technique that I was talking about is a super technique, and it will give you that old charm, very distressed look. You will love it, guys. So all I'm going to do is I'm just going to randomly tear this newsprint part of the paper. I don't want the picture. I already have my picture. So I'm only going to tear this newsprint part of the paper. This is a beautiful, beautiful technique for all your vintage, even mixed media projects. You will really like it. I love doing this. I use it on a lot of my work. So yeah, just I'm only going to tear the newsprint part of it. Okay, so we have all our torn sheets now. And now comes the interesting part. We need a candle. So we're going to light it up and burn these papers. Yeah, burn these papers and give it a nice distressed old vintage edges. Keep a rag cloth next to you. So in case, you just have to slightly run the edges through like this. And you'll get this nice burnt effect, which looks absolutely beautiful when you decoupage with these papers on your... I don't want the straight edge, so I'm just burning it a little more. Do you see this? It's beautiful. It gives a great effect for your projects. So yeah, this is what we're going to do. Just lightly run your edges through the fire. Just at the edge of the flame, not too much inside, so that you get that burnt black borders to your paper. Yes, it's a little work, but the outcome is going to be absolutely brilliant. You will love it, I'm sure. I just love the effect that it gives, the stain and the edges, all burnt edges, gives a beautiful effect. So I have burnt all the edges of the paper that we tore. We have it here. We'll keep this aside and move on to the next step. So yeah, I want to stick these. Before that, I don't want straight edges, so I'm ripping off the straight edges. At the bottom also, the sides are fine because I'm going to stick them end to end, so if there's any extra we can sand it out. Don't worry about the white part showing. I will show you how to later blend it. So I'm taking Kraft Angles decoupage glue. This glue is really good. It's fast drying. You need a very little glue. Before that, make sure your surface is nice and smooth. It should not be bumpy, because if you stick the paper, then all those bumps will show. If you feel it is slightly rough, take a sandpaper and just sand it lightly. The key to a wrinkle-free decoupage work is always the base has to be primed, number one. And number two, when you apply glue, don't apply too much glue, neither too less. You should not leave any area without glue. If you leave any area without glue and stick the paper, the areas where there's no glue, it's going to bubble up and form wrinkles, and later it'll be very difficult for us to remove those. Done this part. Now what we are going to do is we are going to use these and fill up the remaining part and also the sides. Just see how beautifully this is going to give us the effect. All we need to do is randomly take these pieces and just keep gluing them. Just make sure the print is straight, otherwise you just have to randomly keep gluing. There is no set pattern, you just have to fill up the space. This is just going to give you that nice old 1900s kind of a nice vintage feel. And that's all we are trying to achieve here. Overlap the papers and just keep doing this. I just love this effect, guys. I hope you like it too. All those extras we can sand them later. I'm applying a nice generous coat of glue on this also. See, this is also a very important step. Some people skip this thinking, you know, it's a waste of lot of glue, but it's a very important step for a couple of reasons. Number one is this is going to seal your project well. This actually gives longevity to your work also. Number two, after this we are going to do so much more work like painting, stenciling and those kind of things. So when you do that, even if the paint comes on these already stuff that you have stuck, you can, if you have sealed the project, you can simply wipe it off. It will come off easily. So that is also another good reason why you have to seal. But primarily it gives longevity to your product. It gives a better effect. Before I move on to the sides, I'll just take the excess off. So I have completely stuck, you can see here. I finished the sides also. I have just left this strip so that I can continue this as a border. We'll paint that. And I have also finished this. So this is the whole look. Now there are some white spaces here and there. So what I'm going to do is water down the brown, nice and watery. See? And then I am going to keep a tissue ready. This is again another technique you can use to stain a lot of your projects. You can even use to, like, see, I just brush it and then pat dry. Can you see that? It takes on the color beautifully. You have to be quick, otherwise the color will remain there. Make sure you water down the color nicely. You don't want a thick color.
Ma, no need TV. I don't
see that beautiful tinted. It comes out tinted. You can also use this to give your corners that distressed look. We are not looking at a very clean, crisp kind of work here because we want a very vintage look. So even if the brown comes a little bit on the paper, it's absolutely fine. That will actually give a very neat, nice antique look. You can see the difference. We got the corners nicely vintaged. Now, what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to paint all these with a darker brown. I will mix this beautiful Midnight Dreams chalk color from Craft Angles with the brown. See, now if the paint has come on top, since we have already sealed it, you can just wipe it clean. Nothing will happen. I always keep baby wipes handy. Baby wipes are very good to wipe off. So also to clean your stencil, so I always keep it with me. So we've completed our distressed burn, paper burn work. It looks really, really beautiful. I have also painted the back and the sides in a brown. So yeah, that is completed. Now what we will do is we will go ahead and give it a coat of varnish, and this is the varnish that I am using, Craft Angles Decoupage Gloss Varnish. This is very quick drying and it gives a very, very nice gloss. This varnish is very, very effective. You can actually see just a thin coat will give you a nice gloss to your products. So I'll show you the shine. This gives, dries really fast and gives a nice shine. I'm done with the varnish here. You can see a nice shine just with a very thin layer. And now, yes, I'm going to fix this here. I'm going to just screw it here and then I will show you the final product.